The debate over schools and whether to stay in the classroom raging on. In Chicago, the teachers there, the union, voting to go remote. More than 300,000 school children suddenly back home.
COVID cases hit record levels, and tonight, a major showdown in Chicago. City schools suddenly canceling classes. The union calling conditions unsafe, demanding more testing and better masks.
We wanted to shift to remote learning just for a little while until the surge goes down.
This seems perfectly reasonable. Unless, of course, you're Fox News.
I woke up and very, very upset to see what is going on in Chicago. And you have to know, it's not just Chicago. It's everywhere else that teachers unions control the narrative. You have schools closed in Newark and Philadelphia. What do they want? Make no mistake, John, at this point, it is not about the children. As science and data continue to show that the safest place has been in schools, there is negligible transmission in schools as compared to in the community and in-home transmission. And therefore, the teachers union are using this, they're politicizing their wants and needs and putting that over children. This is completely uncalled for. And I want to hear President Biden come out and condemn these people, just like he continues to condemn the unvaccinated. And what we just heard when he said that this is still a pandemic of the unvaccinated. No, that's not true. Actually, vaccinated and unvaccinated are causing this virus to continue to transmit. That is the definition of a pandemic. What we are seeing are higher hospitalization rates amongst the unvaccinated. Stop condemning and stop shaming people who are unvaccinated, yet not saying anything when people are putting our children's life and welfare at stake.
I'm Rayy Vana, and welcome back to Rebel HQ. Dr. Nicole claimed on her Fox News appearance that it's actually the teachers and their decision to switch to remote learning who are putting students' lives and safety at risk. And although she's a doctor, her claims are not supported by the data.
More than a third of 12 to 17-year-olds still haven't gotten their first vaccine shot, and now a record number of children with COVID are going into hospitals.
The overwhelming majority of kids right now who are hospitalized with COVID are not vaccinated, either because they're not eligible or because they haven't yet gone out and gotten the shot.
In the week leading up to Christmas, pediatric COVID cases reached nearly 200,000. But troubling new numbers from the American Academy of Pediatrics show an even more dramatic statistic. The very next week, a 60% jump in cases of children getting COVID, more than 300,000.
As we look at vaccination rates, as kids are able to get vaccinated, only 24% of young students are actually vaccinated right now.
According to an NBC tally, the case numbers are leading to record hospitalizations of children with COVID in 9 different states.
And one of those 9 states is Illinois. This was one of the primary concerns that teachers had when they made their decision to switch to remote learning.
COVID, in a very short period of time, has become one of the leading medical causes of death for children in this country. So I think it's about time that we stopped downplaying the significance of COVID for children.
And Dr. Nicole went on Fox News and did just that, downplayed the severity of the virus in children. She also claimed that schools are one of the safest places for children to be, and there isn't much spread happening at public schools. And Chicago Mayor Lori Lightfoot agrees with her. And she had this to say about the teachers voting to move to remote learning.
I have to tell you, it feels like Groundhog Day. That we are here again at this hour, almost 8 p.m., after everything that we've gone through over the last 2 years with the CTU leadership. There is no basis in the data, the science, or common sense for us to shut an entire system down when we can surgically do this at a school level where needed.
So let's talk about the data that Lori Lightfoot refused to answer questions on. According to the Illinois Department of Public Health, schools are the number one potential source of infection in every region across the state. And as for Mayor Lightfoot's plan to only close on a school-by-school basis, that plan necessitates that a spread has already happened. According to Mayor Lightfoot, students and their families, as well as teachers and school staff, should wait until the harm has already been done and then close the schools after the fact. Both Dr. Nicole and Mayor Lori Lightfoot seem to be more concerned with attacking teachers and teachers' unions than they are about actually keeping students safe and healthy.